Mira, I was worried. How was it? Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing. It's more than a little intimidating.
I'd rather not discuss it, if you don't mind.
Of course not. It must have been horrible. But at least it's over now. Lady Margaery has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back, here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Ah, Sir Jamie, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah!
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour, which I doubt is Dornish for wife.
Put it back.
We're just having a bit of fun. That's probably for the best. I've heard he's a bit perverse. Perhaps Lady Margaery could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen? He does have a certain look about him, and he's always treated Lady Margaery well, which is more than you can say for his mother.
I'd be willing to marry, but not Joffrey.
That's what he thought.
Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden. Let's see, who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match! Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well? Sarah?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was pleased by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over. King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
People are not always so easy to please. If you showed Cersei your true heart, she would stab it with a fork.
You learn very quickly. Your words to Cersei were brave, but I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important. I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her.
I prefer to speak with you alone.
Yeah.
Go on. Ask.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought, if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown, I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
That is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise, but my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire? Joffrey will not look favorably on such a request.
My mother feels it is urgent, my lady. She's unfamiliar with King's Landing and its politics. I hope you can understand that.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
King's Road, Voicewood. Oh, Garrett wieder.
Seven Hells. Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat?
Ich hasse den Typen. Wer macht das nicht?
Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy. What with all that bloody noise?
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets, but the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father was the Warden of the North.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
My lord?
Listen. There. Hear that? I know I heard something. Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
Phew. Ich bin mir gerade nicht sicher, ob ich ihn von vorne sehen möchte.
Bloody hell!
Boah. Das ist ja keine große Überraschung gewesen.
Lord Ethan, as I was saying, you are young. And there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forrester lords stand behind you. Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good. He was fair and wise, and courageous in battle.
And what will they call me?
That is for you to define as the new lord. These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others, the Lord Sentinel. Forester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Keep walking, you creeping son of a whore. Move! Summon the Lord! We need his judgment!
I've done nothing wrong! I was only trying to survive!
Lord Ethan. Maester.
Who is this man?
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed! We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
Is what Sir Roiland said true?
Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks true.
I've a family to feed, and not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here.
Where's our pay?
Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Mercy, no.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter. Most of us won't even live to see it.
We are in this together.
You say that, but it won't be you who's starving come winter.
You'll address him as Lord. Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it is.
Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their lord will not permit it.
He's a thief.
We can send him to the war.
What?
Mercy, my lord. He stole from us.
Oh, nein.
Give us justice.
I will decide.
Send him to the war. Das war meine Befürchtung.
Take his fingers.
He's a thief. If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord. Please, my lord. My family depends on me.
Also, entweder drei Finger weg zur Mauer oder Gnade zeigen. Ich muss aber ganz ehrlich sagen, dass ich zur Mauer schlimmer finde als drei Finger weg, oder? Boah.
Our house tends to its people. See, this man is paid and his family is fed.
Lord Ethan, you are truly a merciful and noble lord.
My lord, this man is a criminal. A brazen thief.
He still serves House Forester and deserves our protection.
He's a rat in our grain stores.
My lord, we must speak about our gold reserves. Soon.
My lord, I thank you for the mercy you've shown me. I will never forget my debt to you and to this house.
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due.
Not just yourself, of course. You can weigh on any lord.
Maester, what do you think?
Me?
Yes. Did I do what's right?
Disloyalty shouldn't be rewarded if others will take advantage of your mercy. You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again.
but a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side. Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance. Possessing wisdom and experience.
And I'm sure you think you'd be the perfect choice.
Me? Oh, gods, no. I can't get involved. I am a maester. At the Citadel, I swore an oath to serve as such. There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here, the bracer of the Sentinel. The badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your sentinel will wear this for all to see. Take it. Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
Wie gesagt, Schweigen ist manchmal auch eine Antwort. Eine sehr, sehr hübsche Armschiene und wir sollen jetzt auswählen. Zwischen ihn oder ihm. Ja, das Narbengesicht ist halt ultra unsympathisch.